Let's talk about what happens when we save our work in Snapseed. Let's say that you've been enhancing one of your mobile images, like this photo here, using some of Snapseed's awesome filters and tools. Just to demonstrate, let me show you what the original image that I captured with my smartphone looked like, and then compare it to where I am now that I have finished processing this image. To show a before and after comparison, I'm going to press and hold one finger against the screen here in Snapseed's main window. Let's say that I'm delighted now with the finished product, the picture that you were seeing on the screen. I bet that you were saying, well, all that Dave has to do now is to tap on the big save button up there in the upper right corner to finish this project. What else is there to learn? And the answer is, you are right about the save button, but the way that this button functions and the choices that it gives us are very different depending upon the type of device that you are using. What happens when you press on the save button is different between Android and iOS devices. Right now, I am on my iPad. I promise that I will demonstrate what happens on an Android device in the second part of this tutorial. But no matter what platform you are using, please bear with me here. When you tap on the save button in Snapseed for iOS, we get three choices. There is a save, a save a copy, and an export option. I'll talk about the export option in another tutorial, so let's ignore that one for now. If you pick the top choice, which is just plain old save on your iOS device, then you are telling Snapseed to overwrite your original capture. Watch what happens here when I tap on the save option. At this point, your iOS device will ask for permission to modify your original file. To finish the saving process here, you need to grant the app permission every time. I'll tap on Modify to allow it to happen. Why the extra question, and what does all this stuff about permissions and modify mean? Well, the simple answer is that overwriting your original file could be a problem later if you change your mind about the way that you process this image and you want to start all over. I don't mean to say that you could never start all over if you choose this option. But let me make what's really happening here as clear as I can. If I hop out of Snapseed right now, and then I go look around inside my iPad's Photos app, what I'm going to find in my camera roll is that my original image is no longer visible. Notice how what you are seeing in the camera roll now is not anything like my original. What you are seeing in the camera roll is the finished product that I explicitly told Snapseed to save over my original image. Now, this is great as long as the image now is really what I want. From here, I could take this image into some other mobile photo editing app and build on the work that I've already done. Or I could share this file right now with the world. But what I can't do right now, what all this fuss is about, is starting all over on this image without first returning to Snapseed and pressing a few more buttons. Let me demonstrate what I mean. To get back to the original, to get back to the image as it was the moment that I shot it, I need to go back into Snapseed. Now, I need to go to the ... flyout menu on the right. And I need to pick Revert to remove all of the changes that I made to this image using Snapseed. Now, I need to tap on the Save button once again, and then I need to choose the first option to restore my original capture back to the camera roll. I'll have to grant Snapseed permission once again to modify my, quote, original file, but now I will have restored what my phone actually saw when I clicked the trigger to the camera roll. Just to prove it, let me hop into the Apple Photos app real quick and show you what the image looks like here now. The point to this demo is to show you that saving over your original capture might be a big pain in the butt if you change your mind about everything you did to an image in Snapseed later on down the road. Fortunately, the smart folks at Google have given us an easy way to avoid this potential headache. Let me hop back into Snapseed, and I will show you how you can prevent this from ever being an issue. To start with, let me return to the dot 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 menu on the far right and bring back my improvements to this image. Now that I have all of my changes back, let's say that I'm happy with this file again. This time, I'm going to tap on the Save button to bring out the iOS Save Options menu. Only this time, I'm going to choose the second option, the Save a Copy choice, instead. This time, Snapseed does not need any additional permissions because this time, it's not going to overwrite my original image. If I hop over into the camera roll right now, you can see what I mean. Down there at the bottom of the screen, do you see my finished product? The one at the end, that's the one that Snapseed just created. In my opinion, this is awesome because now I have my finished product, plus I still have my original image in the camera roll. Nothing was overwritten, so if I decide to start all over, or I want to use that original photo again in some other project, it's right here for me to use. The only downside to the Save a Copy choice is that now you have two separate images that are taking up more space on your device. For most of us, this is no big deal, but if you are one of those people who are constantly running out of storage space on your phone, then creating these additional copies isn't going to help you keep your camera roll as lean as possible. I'll hop over to my Android tablet in just a second, but for you iOS users, let me make it clear that I think this Save a Copy option is wonderful. This is the choice that I urge you to use as long as you have sufficient storage space left on your device. One more point that I want to make clear here. When you use the Save a Copy option on Snapseed for iOS, you are creating a new file that includes all of your Snapseed changes and that you can open up again later without losing any of your editing flexibility. Let me demonstrate. I'm going to go to Open right now. Now, I'm going to go Open from Device. I'm going to slide my finger down to my Snapseed album, and I'm going to pick this image, which is one that I worked on in a previous tutorial. Do you notice here how the stacks counter up there next to the Save button, that little number, says 3? If I tap on the stacks icon, you can even see the layers, the changes that I made weeks ago to this image down there at the bottom, and those layers remain editable. If I wanted to, for example, I could turn off that tonal contrast or turn off that white balance change. I can turn them back on. This is so cool because it means that I can work on an image for a while on my iPad. Then I can save my work using the Save a Copy feature. If the work that I have done is perfect, great. But on iOS, I never lose the chance to revise any or all of the changes that I made to this photo in Snapseed at any time. I can come back to something that I worked on days or weeks ago, and I can pick up right where I left off. Now, this is great. So how do things differ on an Android device? Well, let me switch over to my Samsung tablet, and I'll pull up the same image. Just to prove that this is the same image, let me hold one finger against the screen so that you can see my before and after. There's the original. There's what I've done. But here is what's different. When you tap on the Save button in Android, you do not get another menu or any choices. You don't get any choices because Snapseed on Android always uses a version of that Save a Copy command. There is no option to overwrite the original in Snapseed for Android. To prove this, let me hop into my photo gallery. In my photo gallery, let me show you that here is my original photo. And if I go and look in another album, there is the copy that Snapseed saved. Now, this sounds great. It's great because here on Snapseed for Android, we never have to worry about permanently altering our original. It's great in that we do not have to answer any questions or grant the app any permissions like we saw a few minutes ago on the iOS device just to save our masterpiece. But there is a huge difference here that Android users need to understand. The difference is in the editing flexibility of our new file. Back here in Snapseed, let me open up an image that I've already worked on. I'm going to tap the Open button. I'm going to go to that folder of Snapseed, or that album of Snapseed files, and I'm going to grab this one. This is an image where I clearly made a mistake. I was trying to make this one into a Happy Holidays card, but I made a typo. I guess that I had one too many eggnogs when I was working on this one, because after I made my typo, I saved my work and then I moved on to another image. The problem here, and this is a huge problem, is that when Snapseed saves a copy of your work on an Android device, it does not create a file that you can continue to revise. Notice that the stacks count here says zero. The stacks says zero because the text layer that I added, that goofy Happy Holidays, and all of the other changes that I made have been pressed down into this file, and there's nothing that I can do now to fix that mistake other than starting all over. The moral here is that if you are working on an Android device, then you need to be aware that you cannot easily undo a mistake or revise any of the changes that you have made to your image without starting all over after you have saved and moved on to another photo in Snapseed. This is no big deal if you're working on a simple project, one where a single change is all that it's going to take to make your photo look beautiful. This is no big deal if you take your time and you do good work before you save and move on to another photo. But unfortunately, Android users, every now and then, this limitation will come back to burn you, and you will find yourself having to do a lot of work all over again just to undo some silly mistake. So be careful. I hope you found this exploration of how Snapseed saves helpful. Now that you really understand what happens here when you press save, I hope that you will join us for our next series of tutorials on some of the amazing things that we can do to improve our mobile images using this incredible app.